It's okay.
It's okay.
You rejoin us at a difficult time. We'd been out hitchhiking in the blaring sun for the past 7.5 hours now, the last 5 of which were spent marooned here in Hungary, whose people we were beginning to take a mild disliking to. Meanwhile, over at the Austrian border, Sam was stood in his garage, staring vacantly at the 2 shiny bicycles that he'd found for us, thinking what a shame it would be if they never got to star in the final chapter of our journey. Then, the phone rang.
Really? Oh, mate, that's incredible, man. Are you sure? Mate, that's amazing.
Sam was coming to get us. It was a miracle from out the blue.
So you don't know how much this is helping?
The trip was saved, and all our worries were over.
Thanks, mate, thanks. Bye.
Including the threat of our stomachs folding in on themselves. The only downside was a sense of guilt that Sam had to drive 100 miles to come get us. But that feeling was soon replaced by the excitement that came with the smell of frying Jerry's courgette.
Living off the land, mate. It's not exactly the way that you might have envisioned, but technically we're passing the challenge.
Oh, mate, these are getting soft.
Yeah.
Yeah.
There it is. Can't wait to tuck into this, I'm fucking ravenous.
All it needed was a bit of seasoning and we were good to go. Greg somehow managing to polish his off before I even had chance to turn the camera on. We both could have eaten that meal again. So we did. I mean, Sam wouldn't be here until 10 p.m, so we could afford to eat, relax and enjoy this lovely evening. Turns out the local youths congregate at the petrol station on a Tuesday evening, so we were doubly pleased to see Sam and his dad Robert roll up.
How's it going, mate? Up?
Thank you so much.
Finally,
man.
Here! Yeah.
Hello!
Yeah.
Greg, hi, nice to meet you.
Hey, man, I'm Tom.
Hey,
nice to meet you.
Unfortunately, the footage is far too dark to make anyone out, but the 4 of us had some incredible, albeit a bit depressing, philosophical discussions about society, politics, and the future.
Yeah. The only possible outcome is like war, but that's really fucking depressing.
And those insightful chats continued right up until the moment that the lights came on in Rob's garage.
Oh, wow.
For the same bike, that makes it even better.
That's hilarious.
We couldn't have been happier with our bikes. In fact, it took me right back to Christmas 1994, which is probably when these ones were built. But the point is, we were super excited for tomorrow's shenanigans. Right now, though, it was well and truly time for bed. Oh yeah, we were camping in their garden, by the way.
All right. It feels like the end of the trip in a way.
It does, doesn't it? Yeah.
But it's not. All right,
but it's not,
because tomorrow we're riding on these things.
Our 2 bikes for the day.
Yeah, lovely. I think they will hold until
until
the break.
In the morning, we left a little something in Sam's letterbox as a thank you for saving our trip, and hopped on our bikes for the first time.
Oh, mate, this is smooth. I don't want to jinx it, but.
We made for the village centre, which Robert had assured us had its own bakery. But we weren't necessarily looking to run any errands just yet, see challenge number 5 on the list, but rather to reintroduce things like sugar, fat and gluten into our bloodstreams. Things that we would surely need if we were going to carry out our ambitious plan to cycle to Vienna with our rucksacks on our backs and nothing but a list of towns and villages that we needed to aim for along the way. Now, I know what you're thinking. Bratislava is right there. Why on earth would you want to cycle to Vienna? It's a very good question. The first answer is that we didn't actually know where we were. I mean, I thought we were roughly here. The second answer is that we've been kind of obsessed for a while now with the idea of hitching a ride on a cargo boat down the Danube from Vienna to Bratislava. And we actually had a couple of people working on that for us, one of whom we could stay with in Vienna. But that was a long way off. In this particular bakery, they didn't have a clue what we were talking about when it came to errands. I tried my best to translate the word, but it ended with this old man offering us a permanent job at his friend's vineyard down the road. Well, everyone, these are the noble steeds that are getting us to Vienna, hopefully today. Mine's an old woman's bike, literally from Sam's great-grandmother. And that's from, what, his grandfather, we think? We're not sure. All we know is they're claptrapped, they're rusty. These tyres have more cracks in them than Watford's defence at the moment. And I think there's a good chance that these tyres might go down some way or another in the first sort of 5 miles. What's the first town, mate, we're heading for?
Tadturn,
here we come. Morgan.
Just so glad we're biking, mate, because I've had, to be honest, the guts full of hitchhiking.
I know what you mean, it's just nice to be able to propel yourself and just cruise through these villages.
When you want to start,
Yeah. Making good ground at the moment. It's flat as a pancake round here. Oh yes, that is a bakery, if ever I saw one. Entschuldigung. Village bakery, third village. The lady behind the counter, who I also confused instantly, summoned her son, who not only ran the show, but spoke good English too.
So, anything we can do for you, like post something or get something from the shop or clean the windows or anything?
Yeah, you can clean the windows.
Really?
But if you want, you can come back in the production and you can...
Can we?
That would be even better, actually. As bakery as it can be, the better. That would be brilliant, thanks.
Big boss Michael then left us under the capable supervision of Philip, who had us scrubbing the floury residue from the dough baskets. A job that you'd think would be easy enough, but after your first five, just as your forearm starts to seize up, you quickly realise it's not. And then you look over at Philip and realise that he's actually buff as fuck. And then it all makes sense.
Well, definitely running an errand for a village baker, mate. To say the least.
Say the very least.
This is more of a full-time job, to be honest, than an errand, but, you know, whatever.
But did we deserve a job?
Is it good, Michael?
It's okay.
It's okay.
It's okay. Michael, can you check top basket?
I haven't finished, that's not fair.
Obviously impressed by my work, Michael entrusted me with a proper job.
Thanks a lot, Philip.
Hey, cheers, Philip.
Cheers.
Thank you.
Just one try.
No, the whole thing.
Yeah.
The whole thing.
Okay.
Yeah, hold it on. Oh yes, come to mind. It's okay. Terrifying. It's okay.
Stop.
You can stop. Yeah.
Okay. Tripping over and it falling on. Wow.
Really nice. Golden brown.
Yeah. Wow, they look good.
Seriously, you're backing. I'm happy with that. Very good. Very good.
You did a good job.
Thank you. Cheers.
Now for a sample.
Still hot.
Fucking hot.
Yeah, fucking hot. It'll cool down in our hands.
Ooh. Can we eat it yet? I don't know, man. It's hot.
Good. Just out the oven.
That is the best bread in Austria. I mean, it really is. I ain't joking.
In all seriousness, it was the nicest dough-based piece of food I've ever had. The perfect reward for our hard work with Philip, who we bid farewell, along with Christian, the hardest man west of the Danube, and of course Michael, our new favourite boss we'd ever worked for.
Ciao.
Well, you know, we weren't expecting that in any sense.
No. I was expecting at best like a, you know, the little shop front, the facade. You know, maybe they'll let us. Fucking hell.
Me.
Wir machen die Arbeit. Okay. Ja. Danke, ciao. Genau, ciao.
So, it was on to the next village to see what was in store for us there.
What are you saying, Greg? Game of football in the next village?
Servus.
Thank you, St. Andra.
You have served us well.
Well, we've served you well, to be honest, but yeah.
Fucking hell.
We may have gone slightly off track here. Any normal person would concede that this is not the right way. But we don't fear.
Okay, I think we're actually just lost now. Where are we cycling to today, Greg?
Vienna.
Vienna, apparently.
Unlikely at this point, but you never know.
Which way to Vienna now?
About a mile from our next village, we saw this.
No, that is Chongi Chess, mate. I'm sorry, but it is. Chess,
we may have stumbled across the most sort of, in plain view,
brazen weed farm I've ever seen.
Genuinely confused, we stopped an elderly couple to see if they knew what was going on.
Cannabis?
Turns out they were Dutch. The only Dutch people I've ever met who couldn't speak English. But he could cheers Greg in Welsh.
Welsh,
yeah.
It's Jackie
Dyer, eh? Jackie Dyer, yeah. Ah, exactly, Jackie Dyer. Yeah.
Before having a good laugh with his wife at our expense.
Holder's door.
Yeah.
See if the locals are absolutely baked off their head around here. Tell you what, we're baking. I don't know about baked. It's really, sun's really perking up now.
On the side of the road in Podorf was a series of fruit stalls, which not only offered shade, but bursted with the colours of countless local fruits and vegetables and the various condiments and beverages that can be derived from them. So, we asked the nice girl who worked there about the secret cannabis farm down the road.
Do, like, teenagers come and, like, cut it
no,
and smoke
no,
it?
No, you can't smoke it.
You can't get high off it?
No.
Then she showed us something else that might get us feeling somewhat lightheaded.
This is
and it's all from our home here.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
Really? And what about this?
It's, like, half grape juice and half wine.
Oh, so it's a little bit.
It's here and it's going to.
Okay, the more alcoholic it will become.
Yeah. Do you want to try a glass?
Sure. Yeah.
Why not? Yeah.
You can just sit here.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So we sat back and enjoyed our grape juice wine hybrid to the sound of the local church bells. When the owner of the stall, Stefan, a well-travelled, well-spoken man took an interest in where we were from and what had brought us here to his table.
I'm actually from Wales. Yeah, Cardiff in the south.
One of my favourite really? Cities in the United Kingdom.
Yeah, it's a good city. Yeah. And Tom's from Birmingham.
I'm from Birmingham.
Oh, wow. And what do you do in Austria, especially here in Borisov?
Well, I've got a YouTube channel.
I'm filming
everywhere we go, I'm filming.
Okay.
So we've been doing loads of crazy stuff.
Stefan then fetched his wife, who had recently lived in Redditch near Birmingham, and probably wanted someone she could bond with over its shitness.
So I could escape Redditch even more.
She then too took an interest in our adventure, especially the concept of using as many different modes of transport as we could find.
And we are missing the horses. That would be great.
And another one we wanted was a tractor.
A tractor,
like
a
farmer tractor.
Wait, we have one. Where is it?
Oh my god!
Hold the taxi. You like to eat horse.
Oh, you like to eat horse.
Yeah,
oh, that's fair enough.
Yeah, that is the most kind of cute tractor.
Yeah, it's a little bit too small. It's not mine actually.
Yeah. Okay.
You've been to the lake already?
No.
No.
There's a beautiful lake just down there.
Okay.
Really?
Let's go.
Yeah. We need to pay for the grapes
and the wine.
Yeah,
oh man, that's incredible. By the time we left, their entire workforce was standing by, one of whom questioned the white powder on my hat.
We worked in a bakery for...
We worked in a bakery about like an hour ago.
But we need to see the video.
Yeah, I'll give you the channel.
Right.
Okay, just...
Yeah,
hold on tight.
Hold on tight. I mean, I won't go that fast.
Yeah.
Well... Here's another mode of transport ticked off. Oh shit.
Woo! It's all good. Oh my god.
The ride down to the lake was something I'll never forget.
No refuge needed now.
No. The sun was out, the locals were waving and hollering at us. And we were riding freestyle on a 1961 Austrian-built tractor, thanks to some more staggeringly lovely people. Best of all, we were technically making ground. We were venturing into pastures new. And even though it was only 500 meters down the road, it was more beautiful than we could have imagined.
Oh wow, that's lovely down there.
And just like that, it was over.
Bye.
Well.
Yeah, let's carry on. Oh God, oh shit. We're basically in a place where people go on holiday to cycle. I mean, we genuinely didn't plan that. We just basically stumbled across it. In the next town, we kept our eyes open for football games. We did find pitches, but sadly they were missing players. Hot and hungry, we headed into the centre for some grub.
So, like serving
food.
Sick, mate.
We stopped at an Italian joint where we ordered a garlic-based pasta dish, but with extra garlic, which clearly we had an unexplainably strong craving for some reason.
It smells like garlic and it's fucking amazing.
Well, we asked for garlic, and by Jove, we got it.
It may have gone to Greg's head a bit, though, because just as we went to leave, keen to crack on with some much-needed mileage, he brushed his leg against the wooden decking outside of the restaurant and got a painful splinter. Hardly noticeable on the surface, but apparently very painful.
Gonna need some tweezers for that one, mate, I think.
But as luck would have it, there was a pharmacy just over the road.
Well, that's what we've just extracted from Greg's leg in the pharmacy.
Imagine.
Walter, no?
The stern but caring ladies who worked there had insisted that I performed the procedure, but did reward Greg's bravery with a Star Wars plaster.
Unless you've got like Cinderella.
On top of that, they didn't charge us a cent for the tweezers or the sterilized needle.
Oh, good as new.
Which I almost took with me.
Thank you.
Give me the needle.
Oh yeah.
Otherwise you will be back in time.
Danke, I'll be the same. Bye.
After locating the monstrous void that was Greg's splinter, we set off for our next town, Parndorf.
How's your gooch doing, mate?
Right.
Is it?
The only issue, apart from my aching gooch, was that Parndorf itself was only a third of the way to Vienna, and it was already 3 p.m. At the moment, we'd be lucky if we were there before dark, and that's if we knew where we were going and didn't get distracted easily.
Mate, he's knackered.
Mate, it's a lorry coming,
get it
quick.
Oh, God.
Adder, could be an adder, couldn't it?
Yeah, that's going to make a perfect meal to sustain me to Parndorf. Parndorf!
We basically had to decide between all-out cycling or hopping on a train to give us more time to find a football match. The House of God challenge had sort of slipped away from us a bit. Until now. We'd gotten so hot and bothered on this particularly long stretch that the idea of entering the cold stone shadows of a church was now so heavenly that we both agreed that it definitely constituted refuge.
Oh, at the moment I'm just so hot. I'm cooking out here. Really can't wait to get in there. We've got our hearts set on a church. And obviously it's one of the
aircon store, but
yeah, it could be an aircon supermarket, but
where's the fun in that?
So we ventured our way into Parndorf and started scanning the horizon for a steeple. When?
Oh, thank God. Hello.
Hello.
We've seen a church steeple up here somewhere. We're desperately aiming for it. Oh, there it is.
Look. Oh.
There it is in all its glory. I wonder if they'll take us in.
Legs now weak with exhaustion, we battled our way up to the humbling temple that was Parndorf Church.
Other side.
Oh boy, I don't think I can make it.
Would the church door be open, or would it be firmly locked?
Doesn't look hopeful.
Alas, it was locked. Along with the side door. We were distraught, so much so that we snuck around the back of the church to see if there was anyone we could speak to round there.
There's hope.
And there was.
Hello.
We come from Lichfield Cathedral. We have a look around churches in Germany.
And Austria.
While the first lady went off, the other lady, whose passion for her church is almost reducing me to tears just thinking about it, told us about a brand new painting that had recently come to the church, until the other lady returned with great news.
Okay, come on.
Okay. Oh, danke, danke. We're very hot.
We need to seek refuge, you know?
The enthusiastic pair were more than happy to show us the steeple, the small chapel where I lit a candle for my mate Jim, and the stunning, cool sanctuary of the church nave.
And that is another challenge completed. Thanks to these lovely ladies.
The Kleidung of the Vicar.
Yes, no? Yes.
Danke.
Bitte.
Danke schön.
Danke schön. Tag noch.
Danke schön.
Auf Wiedersehen. Ciao.
As we left, overwhelmed by the kindness and positivity of yet another group of our fellow human beings, we had to take a moment to reflect on it all.
But genuinely, I'm cool. I had a cultural experience, a lovely heartwarming experience, and another challenge off the list.
Yeah. Two lovely, lovely ladies.
Yeah. But, you know, they're laughing their heads off, you know, but
I think today's been about, you know, laughing with other people.
Yeah, meeting people, charitable, lovely people, and restoring your faith in humanity, quite frankly, when you live in a city like Birmingham or London, it's just, I don't know, people don't find the time for each other, but, you know, you come out here and it's just heartwarming.
Yeah.
Now all we need to do is win a nightclub dance-off
and
score a goal in a football game.
By this point, we'd conceded that if either of those were going to happen, or if we were actually going to make it to Vienna full stop, we needed to get on a train. To our delight, there was a train that went straight to Vienna from Parndorf. I mean, if we'd have known that Bratislava was actually 20 miles northeast of Parndorf, we might have reviewed the situation. But we didn't. So, it was on to Vienna to carry out our own, much more stupid plan.
Right, cycling across the huge, busy city that is Vienna in rush hour.
With no helmets, and in my case, one hand, as I'd lost the GoPro head strap roughly here, we aimed to blag our way all the way over to the west of the city, where Paula, Greg's friend from university, was kindly letting us stay the night. During our dicey dash across the city, we'd of course be keeping our eyes peeled for any FIFA street style kickabouts that there might be.
I have absolute confidence that we're going the right way, do you?
Oh, 100%, mate.
No, but we mean that.
But on the football front, the only street urchins we could find were tazzing about on bikes just like us.
YouTuber, yeah!
Football looked like it would have to wait until tomorrow. But we had gone west, and with a helping hand from Burger King's plug sockets,
we've fucking gone and done it.
We found Paula's apartment.
Safe and sound in Vienna.
That evening, Paula took us into town via tram.
What's this, our 10th mode of transport, Greg?
Number 11, I think.
It was actually our 11th, if you include taxis, but we were hoping to make it 12 tomorrow morning down on the Danube, where we planned to flag down a cargo barge. Right now, though, we were down on the Danube Canal, sipping Otterkringers, where straight away the presence of a different kind of boat got us thinking.
This could be what we might be breaking onto tomorrow if things don't go to plan. Basically, it's big enough, I think, to hide, maybe.
It was probably the two Otterkringers talking, but at that moment it felt like a strong option. And as the evening went on, we'd pretty much scrapped the barge idea and were fully in favour of fudging a ferry.
Fuck yeah.
Oh, I'm a gooch.
Meaning we had no time to hunt for footy games.
Wow.
Instead, it was back through the city where we caught a fleeting glimpse of some of its beauty.
Lovely city, isn't it?
It's fucking incredible.
And straight back down to the Danube Canal to try and get on a boat for free. Which, when you're hungover, is a lot more of a scary thought than when you're pissed. Yeah. Especially when this is what you're dealing with.
Right, our original plan of trying to hitch a ride on a cargo boat on the actual river Danube, about 2 miles that way, was just, I don't know, maybe it was doable, but this is plan B. We're going to try and get ourselves on the Twin City Liner. It's a passenger boat that goes from Vienna to Bratislava. If we can't talk our way into it, maybe we'll sneak on. We're going to offer our scrubbing services that we honed back at the bakery. And I don't know, see if we can get to Bratislava in style.
Realistically, sneaking on wasn't an option. If we were going to do this, we would need to put on our best persuasive charm. Because we weren't in the countryside anymore. We were in the city, where money talks.
Hey, hi. Spreading to you?
Of course.
We're doing an adventure across Europe involving, it's going to be a series on YouTube involving as many modes of transport as possible across Europe. And we're finishing in Bratislava.
Okay.
I wondered if we could, in exchange for a trip, we could sort of advertise the service, the brand on the channel. I mean, it's going to go.
The problem is that I'm too low for this decision.
Right here.
Yeah. Okay.
Do you know the guy who makes the decision?
Actually, she's a lady.
Oh, sorry. That's okay. Ignorant of me.
Okay. She's nice, but I don't know how flexible.
Sure.
Yeah.
So
wonderful.
She's Eva. Okay. She's
Eva.
Manager of the Twin City Liner, which goes to Bandcamp. Yeah. You can try and yeah.
See what she says.
I cannot promise anything, but.
Yep,
thanks.
Thank you a lot, mate.
I'll give her a ring.
Yeah. Cheers.
Thank you. Bye.
Okay.
This is the woman, apparently.
Let's give her a bell.
Come on.
But Eva's phone was lifeless.
Nah. Same again.
So, not sure what else to do, we decided to return to the guy on the desk, tell him the boss wasn't answering her phone, and try and convince him one last time to help us out.
But please don't advertise me on in your...
No. Okay. No, I won't.
Yeah,
because
obviously I'm not allowed to do this.
Yeah.
He had allowed us to go on through without a ticket and speak to the captain.
Are you the captain?
Who we explained the whole situation to again, this time putting emphasis on the working, helping out side of things.
Do you have any tasks or like cleaning or anything that we could do here?
Nothing is not for food, but ask the restaurant.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay.
Yes, I will do it in 5 minutes when it goes to start.
Okay, well, we're down there. Thanks a lot.
He was on board. And so were we.
Okay, in many ways, we just want to order like a tuna panini and just chill out on this
chill
boat.
Chill the fuck out.
But what's happened is they've arranged a job for us in exchange for our trip to Bratislava. We have no idea what it'll be.
Apparently it's not nautical though. It's yeah. going to be the restaurant. So it could be pot washing, it could be...
Hopefully not.
But... Well, hopefully not. It could be mopping the floors, you know, it could be...
Could be serving people on a really busy, torrid shift. but we'll see. He's coming over now. Yeah.
But he didn't come over at all. He went straight to his cockpit, leaving us to explain to the staff that we were supposed to be working with them. An idea that this poor guy really wasn't on board with. For a few minutes, we thought we'd got off scot-free. But then, this guy turned up again and led us outside to a little red cabinet, inside of which was a bucket, somehow already filled with soapy water, and this little device here, a squeegee. I always wanted to give this a go, actually, the scrub and swipe, and I have to say, it didn't disappoint.
It's even better than I imagined.
Greg adopted a slightly different technique for the opposite side, but before either of us could even begin to improve our technique, we were done.
€60 saved and two windows clean.
That's roughly 60 beers in Bratislava, so very good.
Very good.
Thanks, man. I appreciate it.
The ferry we were on was actually rapid, and it really wasn't long before we'd crossed the Slovakian border and approaching its capital.
Here we are, Bratislava.
But what did it have in store for us? Well, in the spirit of the entire trip, we decided to wander aimlessly into town to have a look around. In doing so, we came across the perfect opportunity to fool a few tourists. Before making our way past this guy, who almost supplied me with the best footage of the entire trip, past this girl,
up,
who almost supplied me with the most horrific, and to the nearest hostel, where we could recoup and make a speech.
Well, we've made it. We're in Bratislava, yeah. There's the proof. Yeah, I mean...
There's no more travelling to do for this trip. This is the end, Bratislava, and we've managed to get a pretty nice view of the city, really, at sunset. So, no, it's been a great trip. Ups and downs, mainly ups, to be honest. And it's just a great feeling of adventure throughout this trip. It's been so many different countries and so many different experiences. And
so many lovely people.
Yeah, just great. It's just surprising when you put yourself out there, people can be often very willing to help. And I think that's something that we'd all feel a lot better for if we went out and did it.
Yeah, so, it's inspiring.
It's inspiring stuff.
But it's not over. We've still got this town to paint red. Let's do it.
Cheers, boys.
An hour later, we met a sound Aussie guy called Alex and enjoyed a slap-up Slovakian meal and a few beers with him. Nightclub dance-off was still possible. But our chance to score a goal, we thought, had all but gone. Alex thought otherwise. He told us to get back out there and try and find a football pitch and give this one last bloody good go. So, 4 pints down, that's exactly what we did. Having had a quick glance at Alex's Google Maps, we headed back down to the river to try and find a series of pitches located about 2 kilometres upstream.
I've got a really good feeling about this, mate. I really have, rightly or wrongly. We'll soon see.
I want to ride my bicycle, I want to ride my bike. I want to ride my bicycle, I want to ride it where I like.
We We absolutely bombed it along the flat surface of the riverside path, keeping our eyes open for floodlights. Then...
Oh yes, it's lit up. It is lit up, mate.
Oh my God. There is football going on. I don't believe it.
Oh my God. But that's a proper game.
Oh my God. Pissed up in Bratislava. About to join a football game, or at least try. Just trying to gauge the standard here.
It's great.
Oh, it's great. It's absolutely great. Nah. For a while, we watched nervously from the sidelines as big Martin Skirtle-type figures charged each other down and stroked the ball around confidently. Now, me and Greg can both play, but inviting ourselves into such a physical, high-tempo game with potential nutters was a nerve-wracking thought. Even 4 points down. There was another game to our right which looked slightly less scary, but when I spoke to one of the subs, he said that it was just about to finish. It looked like the clash of the Skirtles was our only hope. Or was it? Okay, the far pitch is finished. This one's still playing, but we've just noticed this little game going on over here. It looks a bit less official. We're going to pester them. We approached David Luiz, who was on the sidelines where he belongs, and asked him if we could join in for 5 minutes.
You have to ask the guy in the Barcelona.
No, sure. Barcelona.
Okay. Rakitic. Yeah, he's the boss.
Okay.
Would Rakitic, who was currently putting in a shift, let us join in?
So, you can play with them. They're in dark
jerseys
or shirts.
Sure.
And you can play
with
them.
Also GoPro here, nice.
Okay, could you film?
Of course I can, I appreciate it. I'm a movie guy, yeah, so. Okay, so guy is going to play from Geneva here right now. I hope he get a hat trick. So let's see what this guy's going to do.
Yeah. Okay.
Neymar, right there. Barcelona.
My first contribution to the match, apart from running around like a madman, was to pass the ball straight to an opposition player and then proceed to wipe him out.
Oh, some collision right there.
Not long after that, I was put in goal, where I made a string of brilliant saves to keep our team in front. Some of the more bald-headed men pulled out a few tricks for the cameras. And there were some tidy goals flying in from time to time as well. Keen to prove that I was more than just a goalie, I charged back out and came painfully close with this post-shattering effort. Before coming off on account of not being able to breathe anymore.
I'm fucked, man. Greg, it's up to you now, mate.
Unsure whether I'd kicked my last ball or not, I watched Greg's rasping shot, clearly heading for the side netting, cruelly blocked, before being summoned back on for one last go. And a minute later, thanks to a bit of great determination and skill from our first cameraman, I was threaded through on goal. Surely I couldn't miss now. I'd done it. I'd joined a local football game and scored a goal. But Greg was determined to have the final say, skinning me alive, charging down his favoured left wing, and rattling the post with a venomous shot. I knew he was gagging to score, and with 3 minutes to go in the game, he was teed up on the corner of the box for a chance that required a lot more accuracy than mine did. Needless to say, he slotted it beautifully into the far corner with his magic wand of a left peg.
I'll let you guys play now. I just wanted to score a goal.
I soldiered on for about another minute before calling it a night.
Take care. Yo, Jack Wim.
Thanks a lot, Jack Wim.
Ciao, bye. Put it there, man, we both scored. Both completed the challenge. Yeah! Greg just had to have his goal, which I'd had mine.
I know where I was coming off that pitch, man.
The difference was, Greg's was slotted, mine was sort of fumbled in by the keeper, but they all count, they all count.
They all count, they're all goals.
And that very nicely concludes the story of our adventure. Plans to meet up with Alex and paint the town red never came to fruition because we had no way of finding him.
Bonsoir.
And every bar me and Greg went to when we did venture out was filled with jubilant Croatian football fans. That and my early flight in the morning meant that winning a nightclub dance-off would sadly have to wait until our next adventure. This trip, though, had been about much more than just the challenges. It had been about exploration, mischief, highs and lows. But perhaps most significantly, it had been about people, interaction, kindness, hospitality. Treating others how you would like to be treated yourself. A mantra that's so readily forgotten in today's world. And what of the bikes? Well, it was about time we gave something back to the people of Europe. Much like with the kayaks, we had limited time to get rid of them. But the pleasant waitress who served us breakfast was as deserving a candidate as any. And, in the spirit of the trip, she accepted.
Okay, well, I'll leave this with you then.
Yes, thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Happy laughter or shocked laughter, we don't know. But it was a nice way to end the trip.
Bye. Bye.
Greg would go on to donate his bike to an orphanage in Vienna, but not before we shared the final goodbye of many. Don't you worry though, it won't be the last.